Are you looking to find the cloud projects that are going to help you get hired as a cloud architect or a solutions architect? If so, this video is for you. In this video, we will discuss why most people get the cloud projects wrong, that the cloud projects they're doing actually get them further and further away from that cloud architect or solutions architect role they desire. So let's first talk about what we actually do as cloud architects and solutions architects. And instead of giving you my definition, I'm gonna give you the definition from CIO Magazine. And then I'll talk about which projects actually build your skills versus which projects don't build your skills at all. So if we look at the CIO Magazine definition, where CIOs were asked, what do you want in a cloud architect? They said that they wanted the cloud architects to do these three main responsibilities: lead the cultural change for cloud adoption. And what that really means is learning that organization's business goals, that organization's pain points, speaking to various stakeholders throughout that organization, and managing those stakeholders to develop a cohesive strategy and get the people on board to support it. And then they also say developing and coordinating a cloud architecture. So what goes into that? So with any new cloud architecture, for example, if I'm the lead cloud architect, I have to build an architecture team. Maybe that includes a network architect, a security architect, an IAM architect, an AI architect. It also would include some cloud engineers, some DevOps engineers, some application architects, some software developers. And the point here is we're trying to build a good team that not only will see it from the business perspective, but can holistically look at every piece of the technology and make sure it's going to work. Now, the last thing CIO Magazine said they wanted on a day-to-day high-level responsibility for the cloud architect is for someone to develop a cloud strategy and coordinate an adoption process. And what does that mean? It means we cloud architects are learning the business goals, pain points, challenges, the future goals of that business, the way the business processes operate today, the way they want them to operate in the future. And with that, evaluating their current technology and planning a future technology strategy. So are we going to be on one cloud? Are we on multiple clouds? Are we a hybrid multi-cloud? Do we keep the mainframe? Do we lose the mainframe? Do we keep some of this in the data center? Do we put it all in the cloud? What applications do we need to drive that transformation process? So that's what we're actually doing there. So again, it goes back into talking to people, learning things, re-architecting business processes, leading teams, etc. And then, you know, when they say, what would you like your architects to do every day? They say, find talent with the necessary skills. That's why I've interviewed over 6,000 technology professionals, assess applications, software, and hardware. So seeing what they have, creating a cloud broker team. That's the team that I talked about right now to design the system, establishing best practices for the cloud across the company, selecting cloud providers and vetting third-party services. But believe me, it's not just going to be an AWS or Azure system. There's going to be 30, 40, 100 different vendors involved. Overseeing governance and mitigating risk. Working closely with IT security people to monitor privacy and develop incident response procedures, manage budgets and estimate cost, and operate at scale. So those are the types of things we do as architects. So if somebody does a cloud project where they set up a virtual machine or an EC2 instance, stick something in an S3 bucket, and sets up a website, it has nothing to do with the things that those cloud architects do each day. And that's why people come to me and they've done hundreds of projects, all related to systems administration or cloud engineering, and it has nothing to do with cloud architecture. So those projects don't help the person. In fact, when the manager sees someone that wants to be a cloud architect and all they have is junior level engineering and sysadmin work done, they see the person as not an architect and they're less likely to interview them. Now let's talk about the things that we do as architects, which projects would actually match, that would build your skills. Well, as architects, we respond to a lot of requests for information, requests for pricing or quote, requests for a proposal or actual solution. So learning how to respond to an RFI, RFP, RFQ is definitely something you need to do as an architect and would be a great cloud project because it's actually doing what we do. Now, we architects typically write a lot of thought leadership or white papers for our organizations to show how our technology or our solution will enhance business performance. So crafting thought leadership documents is a real-world cloud project for a cloud architect. What else do we do as architects? We deliver presentations to the industry. So we're constantly going to conferences and delivering presentations. So in fact, the last part of a cloud architect interview or a solutions architect interview is a presentation. So go out there and give some industry level presentations in technology. If you're with us, we would teach you how to go out there and create that kind of audience. But if you're on your own, go figure out how to do it. Go submit papers and proposals to all these conferences until somebody wants to give you a presentation. Now, in architecture, you have to lead teams. So get used to leading some teams somewhere. Now, another critical thing we do as architects is build a business case. So we evaluate all that organization's technology, and we come up with a new architecture, and we have to create a strategy and a business case and our request for an ROA model, or to basically show the return on investment model. So go out there and learn how to build business cases, and build business cases for anything, ideally tech projects, but go out there and build a business case. Now, one of the things we have to do with architects is when we deal with any global enterprise, that there could be 50 different business units. So we have a lot of stakeholders to manage because each one of them cares. So if you want a real cloud product, learn how to manage stakeholders in a global enterprise. That is exactly what we do as architects. Another thing we do is a lot of vendor management. So let's say I'm at AWS. I might have some Cisco systems for routing, some Palo Alto systems for security, some IBM systems for my, let's say, OpenShift, my Kubernetes architecture across my three clouds, because I can't use one of the cloud native tools in a multi-cloud environment. And that's just scratching the surface. So managing vendors, real world cloud architect project. So go out there and do it. Now, another thing we do as architects is we're constantly selling. We have to sell the vision of the architecture. We have to sell people to want to work on our team. We have to sell the architecture to the client, or else it dies as PowerPoint ware and Word documents. It doesn't go anywhere. So great cloud project is to learn to sell. Now, another thing we do as architects is negotiate. We're constantly negotiating with vendors. We're constantly negotiating with stakeholders. We're constantly negotiating deals along with the account team. So go and learn to negotiate and practice negotiating. That's a real world cloud architect project. Now, another thing we do as architects is we cultivate relationships with the client and other vendors. So we're taking clients to lunches, dinners, drinks. We're hosting things like this. So learn how to go out there and cultivate relationships. Go out there and talk to strangers. Go to conferences and have conversations with business leaders. That's what we do as architects. And that's a real world cloud problem and a real world cloud project. Now, one of the things that's really critical for us to do as architects is learn the company's business architecture and work with them to re-architect their business processes. So go out there and learn how to map organizations, how to map their business processes, how to map their org chart, all of it, and learn how to optimize business processes. So one of the other things we do as cloud architects is lead a proof of concept. The customer wants to see if their technology is working. Architects don't touch the technology. We're not allowed to in most businesses, but we may lead, 15 to 50 engineers to come in and build the proof of concept. And we've got to lead them, cultivate that, and bring out the best in it. So these are the kinds of things we do as architects. So if you're on your own and you want to know what kind of projects to do, this is going to get you there. Setting up a WordPress website is not something we do. Writing a Python script is not something an architect does. Learning DevOps is not something an architect does. We are systems designers to optimize our business performance. So now you know the types of cloud projects that'll work for cloud architects and solutions architects. And I hope you understand that, for example, if you wanted to be an airplane pilot, spending a lot of time learning how to fix airplane engines will not get you hired as a pilot. And if you wanted to be an attorney, going to medical school will not help you because it will not develop the right set of skills. Doing real-world cloud projects, and we do these kinds of projects with our students in our cloud architecture development program, and of course our enterprise architect development program as well, because that's what we do as architects. So make sure you either find great architect training where people can teach you how to do these things, which is what I strongly recommend, or go out there and find someone to help you deliver a presentation, and go to the Harvard Negotiation Project to learn how to actually negotiate if you're not with someone like us, and learn how to go to a conference and submit a proposal and an abstract and go out there and present. These are real world cloud projects, and this is how you develop the skills of an architect in addition to actually training and getting the professional development to get there. I hope you've enjoyed this video on cloud projects for cloud architects. If you want to know how to get your first cloud architect job or solutions architect job or enterprise architect job or AI architect job, We have free webinars and free ebooks to guide you in your architect career. The architecture careers are some of the best. Download those free guides. Join us for a free webinar. They're all in the description of this video, and I hope to see you in another video soon. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a like. Subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to assist you in your technology career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now, and I look forward to seeing you in another video.